In this video, we're going to take a look at adding and subtracting integers. And we're going to do that across a CRA sequence of instruction. Remember, CRA stands for Concrete, Representational, Abstract. And in this video, we're going to run that entire progression. We'll show you what adding and subtracting integers will look like for students. The important thing when we're working with integers is not to mess with the abstract problem. We want to interpret exactly what we're given. So we're not going to make any sign changes as we start this modeling process. When we go to transition to the abstract, then we'll set up those rules for students. But initially, we're going to model exactly what's there. So we want to define our pieces. And for this work, we're using a algebra tile, actually. But this is just a square piece, and there's a blue side and a red side to it. And so that allows us to use one side to represent negative. In this case, we're going to use red for negative, and we're going to use the blue side to represent a positive. So if I'm given a problem like negative 3 plus 2, the way that I would interpret that is I would start with negative 3. And so I would model that with 3 negatives. This is an addition problem, so I'm going to add to that model 2 positives. And when I add 2 positives to the 3 negatives, I get what's referred to as a zero pair, which are just opposites or additive inverses. So anytime we have a negative 1 and a positive 1, those are going to add up to be 0. And so this represents a value of 0. We'll refer to it as a zero pair. So the zero pairs cancel out. And we can see that if we started with negative 3 and added 2 positives after canceling out our zero pairs, we would be left with negative 1. In a similar problem, if we had negative 2 plus negative 4, the way that we would model that problem is 2 negatives. This is an addition problem, so I'm going to add to that 4 negatives. There are no zero pairs that cancel out, and so this leaves me with 6 negatives or a value of negative 6. So when we interpret addition, we simply just interpret that as putting more with. Subtraction then would be the removal. So if we had a subtraction problem like negative 5 minus negative 2, this says start with negative 5, so I'm going to show 5 negatives. And I'm supposed to remove 2 of those negatives. So I have them here to remove them, so I'm going to go ahead and subtract those negatives away. And that leaves me with negative 3. Now, one of the things we're going to have to do as we work through a CRA sequence of instruction is be able to tie this to the abstract rules that kids need to be able to live in the abstract. So we know one of the things that we typically ask kids to do is not think about the subtraction of a negative. We ask them to add the opposite. So in this case, we would ask them to add a positive 2. So if we wanted to model that problem, we know we're going to get negative 3, but if we wanted to see how the model would justify that those give us the same answer, we would model the negative 5. And then this is an addition problem, and it's telling me to put with that 2 positives. And when I put 2 positives with my 5 negatives, you'll see that we get some zero pairs, and those zero pairs are going to cancel out, which would leave me with negative 3. And so in this example, you can see how subtracting 2 negatives from the 5 negatives, which left us with negative 3, is the same as adding 2 positives, which ultimately just work to cancel out those 2 negatives and still leave us with that negative 3. And so as we build this concrete model, we're able to use the model to be able to justify rules like adding the opposite. If we were working on these same kind of problems as a representation, we're just going to stop using the manipulatives, and we're going to start drawing the representations that we're looking for. So if I had a problem like negative 7 plus negative 2, that is telling me to show negative 7, so that would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 negatives. And I'm supposed to add to that 2 more negatives, so I'm going to draw on 2 more negatives, and that gives me 9 negatives. So we can see how adding 2 negatives just increases our value of negatives. If I was going to do another example, where they were opposites that we were adding, if we had 5 plus negative 6, I would start by showing 5. That's 5 positives. And because this is an addition sign, I'm going to add to those 5 positives 6 negatives. And now we see that we have positives and negatives, which when we're adding are going to create 0 pairs. And so those are going to cancel out. And we are left with 1 negative, which we would interpret as negative 1. The only situation that we run into where this model doesn't work exactly like that is when we're subtracting what we already have. Let me show you what that looks like. If we had negative 3 minus negative 5, I start with 3 negatives, so that would be 1, 2, 3 negatives, and I'm supposed to remove from that 5 negatives. Well, I already have 3 negatives, but I don't have all 5 to remove. So there's a couple different ways that we can handle this problem. One way is to add in 0 pairs. So we know when we add 0 pairs, we're just adding 0, so we're not changing the value of the model, we're just changing the way that it looks. One way to handle this is to add 0 pairs, add 5 of them. And now that we have added 5 0 pairs, we can remove the 5 negatives. And now when we look, we have some positives and negatives, which are still going to create 0 pairs. And so when we cancel out those 0 pairs, we see that we're left with a positive 2. Another way to do that problem is to start with our 3 negatives. And instead of putting on 5 0 pairs, we can just put on the number of 0 pairs that we need to be able to give us what we want to get rid of. So since we already have 3, we really only need 2 more 0 pairs. And when we add on those 2 0 pairs, that gives me a total of 5 negatives. And now I can remove my 5 negatives and still be left with 2 positives. Now, as we transition from the concrete, which we looked at, to the representation, which we also looked at, ultimately to the abstract. To get into the abstract, we have to be able to establish those rules with our students. Rules like adding the opposites. And when we have this, when we're adding the same signs, we add the absolute value of the numbers and the sign remains. Or when we're adding opposite signs, we're going to actually find the difference and keep the sign of the number with a larger magnitude. So how would we establish those rules? Well, if we're thinking about adding the same signs, if we had negative 3 plus negative 2, we said we would model that with 3 negatives, 1, 2, 3, and I'm putting with that 2 more negatives. And so when I add negatives to negatives, I just get more negatives. So that's one way to interpret adding 2 negatives. We have 2 groups of negatives, and we're just putting them together, which is going to give us a larger group of negatives, in this case negative 5. If we were adding 4 plus 2, we would model that as 4 positives. I'm adding to that 2 positives, and so that would give us 6 positives. So you can see how using these models start to justify the rule that says when I'm adding the same signs, I'm going to add the absolute value of the numbers, and the sign will remain with the sum, which is different when I'm adding opposite signs. So if I have negative 7 plus 4, we would show that as negative 7, or 7 negatives, 4, 5, 6, 7 negatives, and I'm supposed to add to that 4 positives. So 1, 2, 3, 4. When I add positives to negatives, there's going to be 0 pairs. And so these 0 pairs are going to cancel out. And what we are left with is the difference between the positives and negatives, which in this case was 3. And because we started with more negatives, it was negatives that were left over with the negative 3. So we can establish the rule that when we're adding opposite signs, we're going to find the difference between the absolute value of the numbers and the sign of the one with the larger magnitude will remain in the sum. And the same is going to be true if it was, let's say, negative 2 plus 6. If we were going to do negative 2 plus 6, it would be 2 negatives. And I'm going to put with that six positives, so that's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Again, when I add positives to negatives, we're going to create zero pairs. When they cancel, we are left with the difference, which in this case is 4. And because we had more positives to begin with, we're left with 4 positives, or a sum of positive 4. So this will help us to establish the rules as we model from concrete to representational and ultimately be able to live in the abstract.